So we're going to take your picture, and all of you are going to be all over the world tomorrow. So please, warmly welcome here in Boca Raton, Pamela Geller, Atlas Shrugs. Pamela.
Thank you, Tom. I want to thank Tom for helping put this whole thing together on a lark, on the will of free men. Thank you, Tom. My name is Pamela Geller. Can you hear me? Okay.
There you go.
My name is Pamela Geller, and I run the blog Atlas Shrugs. And I want to thank you first and foremost for coming out here. You are great Americans. I see all the American flags. I love it. I went to a radical Islamist rally last month, and all I saw was every flag from every Muslim country, and that was what was missing. The reason why I'm here, and I flew here just for you, from New York City, was because we are witnessing the greatest act of perfidy on behalf of the media, the greatest act of sedition in American history. I have been investigating Barack Hussein Obama for 18 months. And while you may get little pieces of a picture, you have no idea how dangerous this candidate is. Obama is lethal for Israel. He will be fatal for the Jews. Firstly, let me say that it's not one person. It is a timeline. It is a history of nefarious and evil alliances, allegiances, connections, benefactor, mentorships. In his book, Dreams of My Father, he speaks of his father figure, Frank Marshall, a virulent America hater, a virulent Jew hater, a virulent anti-Semite. When he went to Harvard, he was sponsored by Khalid Mansour, who is a close advisor of the richest man in Saudi Arabia, Walid. How did he come to Khalid Mansour? How did a kid from the streets of Indonesia, he grew up in Indonesia. Your American who's running for president grew up on the streets of Indonesia. No mom, no apple pie, no stickball. And you and I both know that America is not an ethnicity. America is a shared value system. Life, liberty, the pursuit of happiness. You have to have it in your DNA. You have to crave it to come here. The immigrants that come here get it. I have documented, starting since July, massive foreign donations of the Gaza contributions, $35,000 from Gaza. I'm going to ask you something that I want you to ask yourself and all of your left-hearted friends. Why is it that everyone that wants to destroy Israel is supporting Barack Hussein Obama? Why is Ahmadinejad, who has vowed to wipe Israel off the map, endorsed Barack Hussein Obama? Why has Hamas endorsed Barack Hussein Obama? Why has Gaddafi endorsed Barack Hussein Obama and admitted to legitimately donating $1 million to his campaign? You have to ask these questions. You have to ask these questions because let me tell you something, ladies and gentlemen, this is not a presidential race. This is a race. This is a fight for the free world. I'm going to speak a little bit more a little later. Nidra Pollard, who is a brilliant journalist, she is an expat living in Paris. Now, who better can describe to you what the Islamization of Europe has done to Europe than somebody living in Europe? And the perception of Obama there and what it means for America and what it means for Europe. Nidra Pollard, would you come on up and address the crowd? I'll be back, I promise.
I think we have to put the mic. I'm the little grandmother. From fundamentally transforming America. Wow. How? You know all about his mentors, his buddies, his interlocking relationships. It's all there on your signs. So I won't take this precious time to tell you what you already know. I hope to give you courage and strength to get that message everywhere you can. We know his wall-to-wall relations are with people who hate Israel. I've been coming to the United States to give talks for years, and I say anti-Semitism, anti-Zionism, anti-Americanism, three sides of the same coin. And if you want to know a secret, I was an anti-American, and I live in France, so I learned my lesson. So I'd like to know, and I wish that we could get thousands of our fellow Jews here, I'd like to know why Greta Van Susteren says that the relationship of Obama with Rashid Khalidi could be a problem with Jewish voters in the swing state of Florida. Why does she understand that and our fellow Jews don't? If the mass media simply told the truth, just plain facts that are verified, Obama could not be a candidate for president of the United States. Never in my lifetime did I see American media so biased, so dishonest, and I have never in my life seen Americans fatalistic. I came here on the 16th of October, and everyone I spoke to, I have lots of friends who are with you, who are with us for McCain and Palin. And every one of them says to me, well, it's lost. There's nothing we can do. I can't believe it. I'm living there in Europe where we have no grassroots movements. We have no Fox News. We have no free media. And if Americans give up, what's going to happen to us then? Obama's policies are no mystery to me. His economic policies, that's a joke. We have that already in France. His little thing, the giveaway he's going to give to people who don't pay taxes. We have it. Pamela published my article about that. It's called the Prime pour l'Emploi. You earn, everybody who earns so little wages, because their economic system, you know, it's so great that people are earning less there. A professor earns less than a guy working in a supermarket here. So they give him a little handout. French voters voted with a very wide majority, with a fantastic, more than 80% turnout, in May 2007, voted for Nicolas Sarkozy to get rid of that socialist economic system. Sarkozy is trying very hard. The financial crisis is not helping him. But not only is Sarkozy trying hard to take away from France that economic system that's caused 30 years of recession with double-digit unemployment and half the population looking for public housing. They don't have mortgage foreclosures. They don't have a chance in a lifetime of buying a home. So, Sarkozy said,
they're living, spend their life, shed their blood, literally and figuratively dealing with this issue for many, many years. You're going to hear from them shortly. For those of you who may not know, my name is Tom Trento. I direct the Florida Security Council and the WatchObsession.org campaign, where we gave out one or two or 28 million copies of Obsession. And we have more over here in the boxes for you to take and distribute. That little program seems to have woken up the radical Islamist community and the angry left. And my experience in the past 6 months traveling all over the United States is that there's this bizarre fusion between the radical Islamist community, the bad Muslims as distinguished from the good Muslims, and the Michael Moore end of the left joining together, hating America, and trying to divide.